Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to see about how to share a Power BI reports in Power BI services. We are exploring Power BI and Power BI services in this. So for the Naga garments, he wants to share the report that he have deployed in Power BI services to his partner or investor. How to do that? Let's explore it in a demo. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. The prerequisite for it is like both the users who were deployed, for deployment, no need of pro. In order to share the report, you need a pro license. The another user also need to have a pro users. Okay, whoever wants to see the report in Power BI, he also should have a pro license. Let us check it in a demo. So currently we are in Power BI services. As we have seen in our previous videos, we have deployed these three reports and we have created the dashboard. So either people can share the dashboard or the reports. So once you share dashboard and reports, you will also share the data sets as well for the user who wants to see. So in this case, let us begin with sharing the report. So go to share. Either you can share it from here, or once you open the report, you can share it from here as well. The share option, both are same. That will lead you to the window over here. So basically you need to type in the email ID in this organization. So we have another user, lax@analyticsnags.onmicrosoft.com. In your case, it's your organization user, okay? And there are a lot of options here. You might have seen allow recipients to share report, allow recipients to build a new content using the underlying data set. As I mentioned before, we are sharing along with the data set, not only the report. And send an email notification to recipients. So these are the options that we have. So you can uncheck it if you don't want to share the data set, only the report you want to share, like that. So these are the options available. Let us try to share as such, then let us see what are other options. So I'm sharing the report here now for this user. The report has been successfully shared. Now let us move on to the another user. Now this user is pretty much new. We don't have any other reports over here, dashboard reports. Everything is empty, if you can see it here at the left hand side panel. Okay, now let us try to refresh as we have got the sharing option. As you can see, this particular user has the sharing option now. So what happens now? He can able to see right now. I didn't tell you, like this particular user, that is lax.analytics, he's not a pro user yet. So let us try to launch the report, what it says. So the error message says like content is only available to the pro users. So this is point number one. The user who is going to view the report should also have the pro license. Okay, that is what it is saying. So let us try for a free license. So let us go for start trial. You got your pro license for next 30 days. So it say okay. So if your organization is providing you the license, then no need of these tips. Now here you can see like who has shared this report. These are the users who have shared this report. Okay, so let us click and launch. Now this analytic, the another user, the lax user, also can able to see the report. He can able to use all the functionality of the filters, filtering, everything can be applied to this user as well. So this is a basic of your sharing of your reports. Now we are back into the main user, the initial user of this report. And let us try to explore other options. Like now you can see like you don't want to give restricted access to this user. So how to do that? So that is something like access, right? So now here this user, he can be able to read and reshare the permission. Now he, you can give only the read option, okay? Or if you don't want to this user to be removed, then you can remove the access. So this is where you can control the access mechanism in this portal, okay? Then what is this manage permission? So this is specific to one particular data set, whether you want to share this data set to this user or not. So specific to each object, you can able to share. Let us try to click on this. So whether you want to share the data set or not, okay, that is what remove access for this data set, and whether you want to give access only to the reports or not. So like that, each object, individual object, you can able to provide the access to the user. That is what this manage permission is all about. So I hope we are clear about how to share the report. The same process applicable for sharing of your dashboard. So even in dashboard, you can mention the name of the recipient, then allow recipients to share the dashboard or underlying data. I will remove this one, and that's it. So you can share it. So now when we go on to another user, that is lax user, then go to home, just press refresh. See here, you got see, you need to go for shared with me, okay? It is shared with me. It will not come under his workspace, okay? It will not come under workspace. Workspace is nothing but something we are working on, okay? So it will not come under in that workspace. It will be come under shared with me. So this user shared this particular dashboard and this particular report. He can able to see same dashboard whatever the main user has created. So now the business has shared his report to his partner, so he can able to verify it, and he is feeling happy. That is different story. If you like this video, share and subscribe to the channel. Comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.